Alright, hello boys and girls, this is Mr. Joe here. We're going to do another Mr. Joe Silly Stretch Time here. We are in Harford, Glen. It's an environmental education center for the Harford County Public Schools. It has lots of cool trails and stuff, so we like to come out here. We're going to do another video, but I got to find my director who is around here somewhere. And, oh, there he is. He's,
hey.
How's it going, Zack? You're doing some reading, huh?
Yes. Reading books. I love reading so much. It just transfers you into your own world. So I just love reading.
Oh, so what are you reading right now?
Right now I'm reading Spy School by Stuart Gibbs. So far the Spy School series has 8 books, and it's about this kid who goes on a bunch of spy missions because he works for the CIA, and he has to make sure that the evil plans that people are planning don't go on. But he's in a tough situation.
Cool. Very good. Yeah, you and Alex have always liked to read. It's something your mom has done that, but this is important because it's March, which is National. What?
Reading Month.
Reading Month. So what got you into reading? Give us a couple of quick examples before we start.
Diary of a Wimpy Kid by Jeff Kenney. It is one of my favorite books. Yeah, it's about this middle schooler and his daily life all written down in a diary that he says is a journal. And you get to see the life of Greg Heffley and his best friend, Rally. And this series has 15 books so far. The most recent is The Deep End. And then another thing that I like about Jeff Kenney's books is he just recently came out with a spin-off to Diary of a Wimpy Kid, Rally Jefferson, journal, Greg's best friend. And there are 3 books in this series. The most recent one just came out on the 16th.
Very cool. Okay, so that is awesome, everybody. National Reading Month, pick up a good book.
Check them out, your library.
Yeah, all right. So we're going to do our first stretch, and since it's sitting, Zach's going to do that. So we're going to start that in a second. All right, our first one is shoulder rolls. So Zach is going to do that for us. And this is a good one to do, especially after you've been sitting doing a lot of reading, I hope. So he's going to show us that. Go for it, Zach.
So we're going to start with like 10 forward.
Good, yep, so you shrug your shoulders up, roll them forward and back, really pull them back. There you go.
All right, and then backwards.
Yeah, let's do back. Good, yeah, we'll do like another set forward. Everybody do them with Zach, okay? You can do this sitting in your chair if you're at home or if you're in school watching this. There you go, roll those shoulders and then roll them backwards. Really roll their shoulders, good. Kind of look like a steam train too when you're doing that. If you like trains, you can pretend you're a steam train. Good job, all right. First one is done.
That's
thank
good.
You, Zach. Alright, here we go, our second stretch. We're gonna work on the arms, and this you can do sitting too or standing. So here we go, you're gonna take your one arm, pull it across your body with your left arm. I'm doing my right over my left here, and I'm gonna pull in with my left arm and stretch my shoulder here, okay? So everybody do this with me. We're gonna do it for 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good job. That stretches a little bit of the tricep and then the posterior deltoid. Anybody keeping track of anatomy? And we're going to do the other arm. Do it with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good. We're going to switch back and forth to the other arm. Hope everybody's doing this with me. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good job. We're going to do one more on this side. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Woo! Good job, guys. Here we go. On to stretch number 3. And that's the sound. of sunshine. All right, here we go. For our third one, it's gonna stretch the tricep muscle, which is on the back of the arm here. So I'm gonna turn sideways so you can see a little better. I gotta flip my cap around. And what you're gonna do is bring your arm up. I want you to reach for your elbow and bend your elbow down. And I want you to, with your other hand, kind of pull it backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then switch arms with me. I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I hope you guys can see this again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good job. Wanna switch sides. Bend your elbows, pull up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Switch again one more time on the right side. Do it with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One more on the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good job. We did it. All right, here we go for our last stretch. It's getting a little warm out here, so I had to, you know, put my sweater off. 80s style, those of you who remember the 80s, height of fashion, putting the sweater around. And if anybody knows anything about Mr. Joe, is he is at the height of fashion. So for our last stretch, we're gonna do a quad stretch for our legs. You know, this is a good one to do. I do this all the time before I go running. So I want you to hold on to something though to help you with your balance, okay? Something that's not gonna move. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna bring your leg up, hold on to your foot, bend your knee, and what I'm doing is I'm pulling with my arm, stretching back, and it stretches the quadricep muscle, which is made up of four muscles. And I'm gonna pull back, and I'm gonna pull till I feel a good stretch, nothing that hurts. And I'm gonna hold 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good. All right, I'm gonna switch sides. See if I can do this without falling. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Switch again. Do it with me. Hold on to something if you can. If you need to. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Awesome. I'm gonna switch sides. And get my balance and I'll let go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Woo! This is awesome. Feeling ready for a run. It's so nice out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Woo! You know what? It is nice. I'm gonna go for a run. Zack, you hold on the fort. I'm gonna go for a run. I'll see you guys later.
End of silly stretch time. We will see you all next time for our next episode of Mr. Joe's Silly Stretch Time.